Chapter 19, Poison. Nancy rolled the robot from the closet and inserted the top secret tape. As the whirring sound began, she warned everyone to stand back. She and her friends waited with pounding hearts to see what he would do. The whirring became louder. Then suddenly the mechanical man was propelled through the swinging door and out to the hallway. He stopped at the foot of the stairs, jerkily raised his right arm, and pointed upward. Ned asked, "Does he mean there's something on the second floor we should investigate?" "I'll bet you're right," George answered. "Let's go up there and see what we can find." She climbed the stairs with Bert. Bess and Dave followed. Nancy said to Ned, "Let's stay down here and see what else the robot does." He nodded, and the two stood at one side of the hall to watch him. "Robbie's moving," Nancy whispered. The mechanical man turned abruptly, rolled across the hall, and went into the den. Nancy and Ned trailed him. "That's interesting," he remarked, watching intently. The robot had stopped in front of Raleigh's desk. Now he raised his right arm and pointed to a certain drawer. "I think he wants someone to open it," Nancy said. Ned offered to and walked forward. He tried to pull out the drawer, but found it locked. "What am I supposed to do now?" Ned asked. "This creature is programmed to be as mysterious as his owner." A moment later, the mechanical man began waving his right arm in a circle. Nancy and Ned looked at each other, puzzled. What did this gesture mean? Nancy made a guess. "Maybe Robbie is indicating that we are to rotate something." "Perhaps it's the knob," Ned said. He turned the knob until it came off. "Now what?" he asked. "Even if this has unlocked the drawer, there's still no way to pull it out. Any ideas, Nancy?" "No." The couple stood looking at the desk for several seconds. Then both of them leaned down and began working on the edges of the drawer with their fingernails. "It's moving!" Nancy exclaimed. Seconds later, they were able to pull out the drawer. It contained a neat pile of papers. On the top was a folded document marked, "The Last Will and Testament of Raleigh Banister." "I'm sure we're not supposed to read this," Nancy stated. Ned closed the drawer and screwed the knob back on. Nancy said, "I'll tell Mrs. Carrier and Thomas about the will as soon as we see them." When the desk was locked, the robot turned and rolled away. They followed him back into the hall. The mechanical man stopped directly under the oriental wall hanging and pointed upward. "There certainly must be a secret in this picture," Ned remarked. Nancy nodded. "It may have something to do with the will." Suddenly the robot turned and began to move forward. They walked after him, but apparently the tape was almost finished. He went to the kitchen and the whirring sound stopped. Nancy removed the tape and locked Robbie in the closet. She and Ned returned to the front hall. Bess called excitedly from upstairs. "Here comes Mr. Meade! Don't let him in!" George, Bert, and Dave appeared at the head of the stairs. "Yes, it's Clyde Meade," George confirmed. "But I think we should let him in. If we don't, how are we going to capture that swindler?" "You're right," Ned called up. "The instant he comes to this door, we'll tackle him." George said, "I'll be right down to help you, but not by the stairs. Every time I've been in this house, I've wanted to ride on the Crooked Banister. Now I'm going to do it." "I'll go too," Bert said. "Let me get on first. You follow." "All right," George agreed. They climbed up. Bert had chosen the banister, which had been sawed off at the wall. Nancy was about to suggest they switch to the other railing, but it was too late. George and Bert had started down. Their twisting descent was so swift they were almost swung off. "It's like riding a roller coaster," George cried. As they neared the bottom, both she and Bert grabbed the rail hard and tried to stop, but they were not able to. The next moment, there was a loud crash. A gaping hole appeared in the plasterboard wall, and George and Bert disappeared through it. "Oh!" screamed Bess, who was halfway down the stairway. Nancy and Ned rushed to the opening and looked inside. George and Bert were just picking themselves up from the floor. "Are you hurt?" Nancy asked quickly. Before George and Bert could answer, a solemn voice announced hollowly, "Now you cannot escape! You're trapped among the poisons!" The dire message was repeated. End of chapter 19.